We're also, thanks to advances in communication technology, we're living in a world where hundreds of millions, if not billions of people today can connect to each other. In some countries, it's slightly restricted. The restrictions are going away. There are gatekeepers. I'm not saying they're not there. Thomas Friedman spoke a long time ago about the world going flat, but we're feeling it. But 40-something years after the advent of the internet, we're now in a moment in time where we're connecting. And we're connecting not just and sharing stuff, we're listening too, and we're feeling. And we're in a world where 7 billion people have a voice and every voice matters. And what's remarkable about the stuff we're looking at is that the social change I'm seeing, and I think you're living through, is that everyone's voice matters to you sometimes. And that you have this ability to randomly say something else, where a perfectly total stranger will repeat your message to their people. What's happening is that there's an awakening. 85 years ago, a modern artist actually didn't put human beings in art. They felt humanity was dead. I would argue if any of those artists were alive today, they would actually start putting humans back in the art. Because one of the things that I'm seeing is a rise of humanity, of the human spirit in modern times. And if you look at all the major social things, whether it's communism, fascism, capitalism, Marxism, this is not Twitterism, it's not Facebookism, maybe it's internetism.